Hello everyone. Today I am here to discuss about boiling and condensation chapter of module 5. So boiling and condensation both are phase change process, where in boiling the liquid phase is converted into vapor phase, while in condensation the vapor phase is converted into liquid phase. Okay, so in boiling as well as in condensation, heat transfer takes place and in boiling heat transfer takes place from solid to liquid, while in condensation the heat transfer will takes place from vapor to the adjacent solid. So both are forms of convection heat transfer, as there is a existence of flow of a fluid in both the cases, that is in boiling as well as in condensation. So now the rate of heat transfer as well as the heat transfer coefficient in boiling as well as in condensation are very high compared to your normal the heat transfer, because there exists a phase change process. So this phase change process occurs by absorbing the latent heat when the liquid is getting converted into vapor. So it absorbs the latent heat and gets converted into vapor. So even in condensation, that latent heat is the vapor phase gives its latent heat to the adjacent solid and gets converted into liquid phase. So this latent heat is very important parameter, as this is the driving force, you can say, which is associated with phase change. So in both the cases, very important parameters, or you can say the properties, are: one is the latent heat, second one is the surface tension of the liquid, and the third one is, you can say, the buoyancy forces. The buoyancy forces are called as the forces that is due to density differences. Okay, so this boiling and condensation are used in many industrial applications or in many engineering applications. So a very good example is boilers, where your water will be converted into steam, or you can say gas. So even in a vapor compression refrigeration system or in a vapor absorption refrigeration system, these boiling as well as condensation is used. So in evaporator as well as in condenser. So like this, you can have many applications for these both boiling as well as condensation. So today, in today's session, we will discuss about boiling heat transfer, and in the next session we will discuss about the condensation part. So before going to what is meant by boiling, it is better to know what is meant by evaporation as well as boiling. That is, what is the difference between evaporation as well as boiling? Because evaporation is also a phase change process and boiling is also a phase change process. In evaporation, the liquid is converted into vapor phase. In boiling also, the liquid is converted into vapor phase. But the evaporation can occur at any temperature, but boiling is going to occur only when it exceeds the boiling point. As we know, what is the boiling point of water? It is 100 degrees centigrade. So your water is going to boil only when the liquid temperature crosses the 100 degrees centigrade. Okay, so but evaporation will take place at any temperature, because the liquid molecules which are at the free surface, you can say the free surface of the liquid, whatever the molecules, liquid molecules which are present, we will have high kinetic energy, and these high kinetic energy molecules will escape from the liquid surface, the free liquid surface, by converting into vapor. So this process is called as evaporation. You can say evaporation is going to occur at liquid vapor interface, when the vapor pressure is less than the saturation pressure of the liquid at any given temperature. Now you have a glass of water which is at 20 degrees centigrade and surrounding atmospheric air. Now it is kept in atmosphere which is surrounded by air. So the liquid molecules which are at the free surface, they can escape because of this evaporation process. So for very good example for this evaporation process is water cycle. Water cycle. So, and you can say you can see the free surface of the liquid that is present in lake or rivers or in sea, we will be converted into vapor phase because of the solar energy. So the upper surface of the liquid present in the river will get heat because of the solar energy and will be converted into vapor, and this process will be called as evaporation, not boiling, because boiling is one which takes place at solid liquid interface. Solid liquid interface, when a liquid is brought near to the surface, and thus that surface is maintained at a temperature higher than the saturation temperature of the liquid, or you can say the boiling temperature of the liquid. Okay, so now you can see here you have a pan which is filled with water, and now the bottom surface of the pan is given with the heat. Now the liquid which is in contact with the bottom surface of the pan will gets heat, and then gets converted into vapor, or you can say bubble, and that bubble will move up to the free surface of the liquid. So as the temperature of the bottom surface of the pan increases beyond the saturation temperature of the water, then boiling is going to occur. Okay, so you can say evaporation and boiling process. In evaporation as well as in boiling process, the liquid phase is going to convert into vapor phase, but evaporation is going to occur at any temperature, but boiling is going to occur only beyond your boiling point of the liquid, and it is going to occur at solid liquid interface. Okay, so boiling can be classified based upon the bulk fluid motion. So because boiling is a bulk phenomena, so if we keep water in a pan, so everywhere the water will gets boiling, so not at a particular part, but the evaporation is a surface phenomena. So it takes place only at the free surface of the liquid. Upper surface of the liquid is getting heated and it's get converted into vapor, but in boiling the bulk fluid gets started into boiling process. Okay, so based upon the bulk fluid motion, your boiling can be classified as pool boiling and another one is flow boiling. So in pool boiling the fluid will be stationary, that means there is no motion of the fluid. So you can say the bulk fluid motion is absent in case of pool boiling. Okay, so and any motion that causes because of the transfer of heat from the bottom surface to the adjacent liquid, it is due to the natural convection, and the bubbles which moves in the boiling is due to the buoyancy forces. Okay, just one thing is very important is in pool boiling the motion of the fluid will be absent. Motion of the fluid is absent. Okay, so good example for pool boiling is a pan which is filled with water and given with an heat at the bottom surface. Okay, so next one is flow boiling. Flow boiling means the fluid motion will be present in this case, and example for this flow boiling, you can consider a pipe where a liquid is flowing inside the pipe and the circumference of the pipe is given with an heat flux or an heat. So the liquid which is very adjacent to the circumference of the pipe will gets heated up and gets converted because when the surface temperature increases beyond the saturation temperature of the liquid, there exists a boiling. Okay, so this is a good example for boiling. That means there is a flow of liquid. So you in order to flow the liquid through the pipe, you may use a pump, or you can use any external agency to pump the fluid. Okay, so in pool boiling the bulk fluid motion is absent, in flow boiling the bulk fluid motion is present. Again Again, this pool boiling as well as this flow boiling can be classified into two categories. One is a subcooled boiling, another one is saturated boiling. So now consider a pan which is filled with water. Now the water which is filled in the pan is having 80 degree centigrade, and the surface, now the bottom surface of the pan is heated, and the temperature is around 107 degree centigrade. So now the temperature of the water, or you can say the temperature of the liquid that is present in the pan, is less than the saturation temperature of the water, because the saturation temperature of the water is 100 degree centigrade. But whatever the water that is present here is having 80 degree centigrade. So it is less than the saturation temperature. So when the liquid that is present in the boiling is having a temperature which is less than the saturation temperature of the liquid, then this type of boiling is called as the subcooled boiling. Okay. So in case of a saturated boiling, the liquid that is present in the pan will have the temperature equal to the saturation temperature. So now the saturation temperature of water is 100 degree centigrade, and the water that is present here is also having 100 degree centigrade. So this type of boiling is called as saturated boiling. Now, so in classification, you can say the boiling can be classified into two categories. One is pool boiling and flow boiling. Again, this pool boiling as well as flow boiling is classified into subcooled boiling and saturated boiling, depending upon the temperature of the liquid that is present in the. So the boiling process is a form of convection heat transfer. So the rate of heat transfer for convection is calculated based upon the Newton's law of cooling. So for boiling also, you can use the same formula from the Newton's law of cooling. We can calculate what is the rate of heat transfer. And the rate of heat transfer is given by Q equal to delta T. Delta T is the temperature difference that exists between the surface, the heating surface, and the liquid, the temperature of the liquid which is present in the boiling. So now, in this case, we will consider the delta T as TS minus Tsat. So where your TS is nothing but the temperature of the surface, or you can say surface temperature of the solid, and Tsat is the saturation temperature of the liquid. Okay, and A is the surface area that is available for the heat transfer, and H is the heat transfer coefficient. Now send this A to the left hand side, then it becomes Q by A, that is equal to H into Ts minus Tsat. So the rate of heat transfer per unit area is nothing but the heat flux. So your this Q by A becomes a small q, that is a heat flux equal to H into Ts minus Tsat. So now this Ts minus Tsat, as your the temperature of the saturation temperature of the liquid remains constant. For example, for water, the saturation temperature is 100 degree centigrade. So this will remain constant. But depending upon the heat that is supplied to the surface, the temperature of the surface is going to change. So based upon the surface temperature, we can calculate what is the difference, that is a Ts minus Tsat, and we can say that this is the excess temperature. The excess temperature that is above the saturation temperature of the liquid. So your Q can be calculated as H into delta T excess. So the rate of heat transfer in boiling can be calculated as Q equal to H into delta T excess. Okay. Now we will discuss about the pool boiling reasons. The scientist called Nukiyama in 1934, he considered water as the fluid and in pool boiling, and he conducted various experiments on water. in pool boiling, and he found that there exist different reasons depending upon the excess temperature. Okay. So now, for different excess temperature, he calculated what is the rate of heat transfer, that is the heat flux, and he plotted the graph between heat flux and the excess temperature. Okay. So this graph, which is shown in the figure, is a typical graph which is for water at one atmospheric pressure. Okay. So depending upon the excess temperature, he found that there exist four different regimes in pool boiling. So the four different regimes that exist in pool boiling are: one is the natural convection boiling, second one is nucleate boiling, third one is transition boiling, and the fourth one is film boiling. Okay. So depending upon the excess temperature, the different boiling regimes are going to exist. Now, for example, your natural convection boiling exists when your excess temperature lies between 1 to 5 degrees centigrade. And nucleate boiling regime is going to exist when your excess temperature lies between 5 to 30 degrees centigrade. Similarly, the transition boiling regime is going to exist when your excess temperature lies between 30 to 120 degrees centigrade. And after 120 degrees centigrade, the regime is called as the film boiling. Okay. Now we'll discuss the one by one these regimes. Okay. The first one is the natural convection boiling. So in this boiling, as your excess temperature increases, your rate of heat transfer increases. As we know, the rate of heat transfer also depends upon the excess temperature. Okay. So the rate of heat transfer increases as your excess temperature increases. Now, if you see this figure, the liquid which is adjacent or which is just above the surface, the bottom surface, will be superheated. And because of the superheating, now this liquid moves to towards the free surface. So the fluid motion that is going to happen in this mode is due to natural convection, due to the buoyancy driven forces. Now the rate of heat transfer in this case is also calculated based upon the natural convection heat transfer. And this natural convection boiling is going to exist when your excess temperature lies between 1 to 5 degrees. That means it is just above the saturation temperature of the water. So the next regime is the nucleate boiling. So in this boiling regime, the excess temperature lies between 5 to 30 degrees centigrade. And at 5 degrees centigrade, you have a point A. So at this point, there is going the bubbles are going to start, or you can say the bubbles are going to form on the bottom surface of the pan. So this point A is called as the onset of nucleate boiling. That means the formation of the bubbles is going to start at point A, and the bubbles are going to form at different locations of the bottom surface with increasing rate. So the rate of heat transfer increases as your excess temperature increases. So here there are two distinct regimes exist in a nucleate boiling. So one is the region between A to B and the region between B to C. So in region between A to B, the bubble will form on the bottom surface. That means an isolated bubble. So single bubble will form on the bottom surface of the pan. And this vapor bubble, now it detaches from the surface, bottom surface, and it moves towards the free surface of the liquid. But it is unable to move up to the free surface of the liquid, but it collapses in the liquid itself. So the space that is evacuated by the bubble will be filled by the fresh liquid, So there is a mixing motion is going to happen, and there is agitation also. This agitation is due to the disturbance of the fluid. So now, because of the disturbance of the fluid and because of the mixing motion, the rate of intertransfer in this region is going to increase as your excess temperature increases. But the increasing rate is higher than whatever that is exist in natural convection boiling. So this increasing rate in the rate of heat transfer is due to mixing motion as well as due to the, you can say, the evaporation. So in region B to C, the formation of the vapor bubbles are continuous. And these bubbles will detach from the surface and they will move towards the free surface of the liquid. That means they will move upwards until it reaches the top surface of the liquid. So when the bubble reaches the top surface of the liquid, it collapses by giving up the heat. So the fresh liquid which is taken the place of the vapor bubble which is left from the surface, now again it gets the heat and it gets converted into vapor bubble, and this vapor bubble will again it follows the same line. Now the vapor bubbles which are formed at different locations are, you can say, not different various locations of the surface, bottom surface of the pan, will increase, and these will form like a column in the liquid. So as the number of vapor bubbles, the formation of the vapor bubble increases, so these vapor bubbles will act as some insulation. So because of that, the rate of heat transfer, the increasing rate of heat transfer is not that much as compared to your region A to B. So it reaches up to a maximum of point C in the nucleate boiling, and this point C is called as the critical heat flux. Okay, so the critical heat flux is the one where the maximum heat transfer is obtained in the pool boiling. Okay, so this is about the nucleate boiling. You have two regions A to B and B to C. In A to B, isolated bubble forms and it collapses in the liquid itself when it moves from the surface, but in B to C, the vapor bubbles rises up to the free surface and it collapses after reaching the free surface of the liquid. So the rate of heat transfer in nucleate boiling, you can say, it is due to agitation and the evaporation of the vapor bubbles. So now as the excess temperature increases further, the rate of heat transfer in the transition boiling is going to decrease because the formation of the vapor bubbles on the bottom surface of the pan increases. So these vapor bubbles will act as insulation because the thermal conductivity of these vapor bubbles will be less compared to less. Okay, so it acts as an insulation, or you can say insulator. Now you can see here the vapor pockets are more, so the area that is available for the heat transfer at the bottom surface will decrease. As your area decreases, area for the heat transfer decreases, the rate of heat transfer decreases. So because your Q is directly proportional to area. Hence, the rate of heat transfer in transition boiling is going to decrease as your excess temperature increases. And it reaches to a minimum point at D. Okay. So this point where a minimum rate of heat transfer is going to occur is called as a Lehden-Prost point. So the further increase in the excess temperature increases again the formation of the vapor bubbles on the bottom surface of the pan. So these vapor pockets will be continuous on the surface, and these will be like a vapor film. So these vapor pockets, as they form continuous on the surface of the bottom surface of the pan, so now it will be like continuous. So this will be then vapor film. So this vapor film will have will now act as a medium for the rate of heat transfer from the bottom surface to the liquid which is present in the pan. So conduction heat transfer also takes place through this vapor film, and the radiation also takes place through this vapor film to the liquid. So now because of the combined mode of conduction as well as the radiation, the rate of heat transfer increases from point D as your excess temperature increases in the film boiling, because this is called as a film boiling because a vapor film is going to form on the bottom surface of the pan. So this is about the pool boiling reasons. You have four different reasons: natural convection boiling regime, nucleate boiling regime, transition boiling regime, and film boiling regime. So the rate of heat transfer for different reasons is different. The rate of heat transfer for different reasons is different, okay, depending upon the excess temperature.